you know, situation with the dog, you know, getting caught underneath the green line a couple weeks ago. And I had seen the story, and, you know, I own bully dogs, I own pit bulls. I got a kennel myself, and, you know, I got a truly deep love for this animal. And I wanted to help, so, you know, I reached out to Tia at Pit Bulls and Paroles, just, you know, told her the story, and she's like, she was on the way, and she here, and, you know, it's a good thing for the city, and it's a good thing for, you know, little Zeebo, and, you know, to be rescued, and, you know, have another life, and have a chance to be with a family one day. That's why we're here. And
how's he doing?
He's doing good. You know, he's a little skittish. He was trapped for about, they say, about 2 or 3 days underneath a little pipe. I mean, pipe wasn't that big, and, you know, it's remarkable that he's still alive, and thanks to Mario and to, you know, the mother and the daughter that was walking on the green line that heard him. So, I mean, it's a blessing, you know. It's a blessing for me to be able to be a part of this, and for this dog, life, to be still alive.
Why is this dog so special for you?
Just because, you know, I deal with this dog. I deal with pit bulls. I got, you know, 8 or 9 of them. I breed them. I sell pups. I take them to shows. And, you know, everybody look at pit bulls as bad things, but people got to understand that, you know, they got to do, you know, they do diligence and understand that it's a good dog, and it's a, you know, it's like any other dog. It depends on how you treat them and raise them.
And you're a fan of the show?
Donate? I donated $10,000 to the rescue center, and, you know, possibly be more, you know, because, you know, this is my love. You know, I love dogs, you know, and animals, period. So, you know, hopefully I can do something and be a part of Memphis Humane Society and do stuff here as well.
What'd you think about them naming it Little
Zeebo? Man, it's a great name. I like it. I'm gonna be checking up on it. I might adopt the dog back and, you know, bring, you know, to Memphis and let him live with me. I'm thinking about it, but I'll keep in contact with Tia and see how the dog rehabilitation going and go from there.